this biryani show. Let me show you what are the ingredients you will need for this. To begin with, soak 3/4 cup of basmati rice in water for 30 minutes. And meanwhile, we will make other arrangements. In a blender, add 5 cloves of garlic, 5 pearl onions, 2 inch size of ginger, some coriander and curry leaves. Adding pearl onion really makes your biryani taste great, so try to add them for sure. Blend them into a smooth paste and keep them ready. Now, heat pan on your stove and add 1 tablespoon of ghee, that is clarified butter, along with 2 tablespoons of oil. Once your ghee is melt and it is hot, add whole garam masalas like 2 inch size of cinnamon, 1 star anise, 1 cardamom, 3 cloves, and just sort them for a while till you get nice aroma. And now it's time to add your bay leaf and 1/2 teaspoon of fennel seeds. Just sort them for a while. And then I'm going to add 1/2 cup of onion cut into lengthwise along with 1 spring of onion. Just sort them till raw flavor goes and they are slightly translucent. So now you can see my onions are slightly translucent. And now it's time to add tomatoes. I'm just going to add a very little bit of tomato, just a 1/2 tomato, not more than that. Just 2 tablespoons of tomato is enough. I have chopped them. And along with it, I'm going to add the ginger garlic onion paste. Just mix it up well. And sort it for at least 3 to 4 minutes till raw flavor of the ginger garlic goes. And I'm going to add the mushrooms, which are washed and cut into thin slices. And along with it, I'm going to add 1/2 tablespoon of red chili powder. And if you want it to be less spicy, you can reduce the amount. And 3/4 tablespoon of coriander powder and 3/4 tablespoon of cumin powder. And I'm going to use a biryani masala. You can get it in Indian grocery stores. I'm just going to add 2 teaspoons of biryani masala. And if you don't have, you could also replace it with garam masala powder. So now add a very little bit of water to avoid burning. And just mix them well with your mushroom. And add required amount of salt. And give it a mix once again and just cook it for just 2 to 3 minutes till the mushrooms are shrink and so I just cooked for 3 minutes and now they have started to sizzle and the mushrooms are shrink a little bit. And I'm just going to transfer it into the pressure cooker. So now add your soaked rice along with water into your pressure cooker. And the measurement while making biryani in pressure cooker with basmati rice is for 1 cup of basmati rice, you can add just 2 cups of water only, not more than that. But considering the gravy as 1/2 cup, I just added only 1 1/2 cup only. So 1 1/2 cup of water with 3/4 cup of rice. And the gravy, so just give it a mix and check for the salt. And if you feel the salt is very less, you can add salt at this point of time, because we added salt only for the mushroom gravy, and I'm just adding salt for the rice we added now. And while you taste it, the salt should be a bit extra, so that once it's cooked, the salt will be okay. And now I added some coriander and mint leaves, and finally I'm going to add around 7 to 8 cashew nuts. So you can even roast them in ghee and add, but I'm just adding as it is, and just give it a mix once again. And once you see your gravy and the rice starts to boil, you can just cover it with a lid and let it to cook for just 1 whistle. That is enough. And later 1 whistle, just simmer your flame and let it to sit the pressure cooker for 5 to 7 minutes, not more than that, in a simmer flame. And your biryani is ready. Just allow the pressure to completely down, and then you can serve it with your favorite yogurt raita. So my delicious and superb mushroom biryani is ready with the pressure cooker, and you can see the rice is separate as we made in the dum biryani. So it is very must you have to add right amount of water. Please visit my blog for more information to make this biryani. Thank you so much for tuning in. Do subscribe and hit the like button if you like this video. Bye bye and have a nice day.